everybody. Hi. Welcome. Are you in for some fun? It should be a great evening. I'm really excited about it today, tonight's events. So I get the honor of introducing our founder. I'm going to start with, this year marks 20 years since the Byron Saunders Foundation has started providing Thanksgiving meals to families. Our founder started 20 years ago providing 50 families Thanksgiving meals, and last year we provided 4,500 families with meals. Our goal this year is to do 5,000, and it's going to be a tough challenge, but we're up for it, right? Yeah. All right. So I wanted to share some information with you about Brian, our founder. Brian is our founder. For 20 years, Brian has worked to expand his efforts to reach as many people as he can to feed families in need. He works tirelessly. He surrounds himself with people that share his vision. Board members can expect a thank you, and I appreciate you and all that you do regularly. He's well loved for his compassion, and people truly want to help him. Brian is always the optimist. He's always willing and smiling and finds the light in every situation. His faith in the Lord is unwavering, which is very true. Whether he's organizing a food drive with a business or seeking donations, Brian can be found every single day working to serve the community. He has met every life challenge head on his entire life and is unlike anyone you have ever met before. I'd like you all to meet Mr. Brian Wallenberg.
Thank you, Gina. Appreciate it.
Thank you all. Appreciate it. Just want to say a few words. Thank you all for being here. Everybody can do something, and I just value every one of your beings and who you are. Byron Saunders does not exist without volunteers, and I'm so gracious for all our board members, to Katie Tombaugh for putting this whole event on, and Susie Wagner, and all the volunteers, and just the list goes on and on and on. And it's about networking and relationship. What's relationship mean? Relationship means connection and engagement. And this is what's created by engagement and relationships. And it just builds. And it feels great to help the community. And so it's a blessing to serve others. And it's continued. It doesn't stop just at Thanksgiving, but it's continued in small things too. So, but I just want to acknowledge everyone for you being here and taking the effort to make Byron Saunders what it is. So thank you for all that. One other thing I'd like to say is I'd like to acknowledge some of our partners and sponsors. And our first, the headline sponsor, Jeff Winterstein with Infrasource. He's sitting over here. Thank you. And then next I would like to bring up Monty from PSI. They are our media sponsor.
Okay, we want to get to see some dancing quick, so I'm going to get out of here as quickly as I can. I don't know how the headline sponsor got away with just a wave. How did that happen? But anyway, Protein Solutions, this is our first year being a partner to this event. I hope it's not our last, especially after one of our owners wins this event, Monica Dominic. Protein Solutions, we're an information technology services and staff augmentation company here local. And I get the privilege to introduce our MC for tonight. That's why I'm really up here. And our MC for tonight is none other than NBC4's meteorologist, Liz McGiffin.
Thank you. Hey, welcome everyone. Thank you so much for everyone.
everyone who has already contributed so much to such a great organization. This will be my second time being here. Had a chance to perform a couple of years ago. So thank you everyone who's been here. Either it's your first time, you've been here a couple times already. This is such a fun event. And if this is your first time, get ready. You're in store for a really great show. I want to make sure that we point out a few things by now. Hopefully you've enjoyed your dinner. You figured out right over there in the back corner, that's where the cash bar is. So that's going to be staying open. In case you haven't figured out where the drinks are coming from, it's that way. And there's going to be three separate awards this year that we give out. And there's a couple of ways that people get those awards. Of course, they're going to be an award linked to the performances. But the reason that we're all here, it's to raise money. And so I want to remind everyone, if you've been trying to figure out, you know you want to donate the money, you're trying to figure out who to give it to, throughout the night, we've got till 9:30 to get those votes in. $1 donated equals one vote. And we made it really easy for you, too. If you open up your program, you'll be able to scan a QR code. You'll be able to put in a vote that way. So keep that in mind. We've also got people walking around who will be able to help you out. So the program's going to be your friend, especially when you get to put in your own personal vote for your favorite couple or your favorite dance performance. Now, as far as the performances go, you probably know if you've been looking online, look through the program, we've got 8 very entertaining performances. So that means that we're going to have at least 16 very talented dancers out here on the floor. And again, there are endless ways to continue to donate, even if it's not necessarily that $1 donation for the vote. Even if you go to their website, you can donate all year long to this wonderful foundation that makes sure that families are able to be fed all across Central Ohio on Thanksgiving. So yeah, thanks so much for everyone who continues to donate all year long and not just at this amazing event. And with that being said, there is a video that we want to make sure that we get to make sure that you guys kind of know really the purpose of why we're here. All of the sparkly dresses and the dance performances, it's a bonus, but there's a bigger purpose behind what we're doing here.
The Byron Saunders Foundation's mission is to provide Thanksgiving meals to families in need.
We start collecting food for Thanksgiving in December.
And we're always looking for people to take on food drives, community centers, grocery stores, any place that everyone frequents on a regular basis where we can collect food items so that we don't have to rely on all of those donations to go purchase those items to fill the boxes later on. This is what we really need.
We log it all in, every can of green beans, every box of stuffing, every jar of gravy. One of the ways that we get recipients for the food are requests that are made on the Facebook page or our website. When these requests are made, somebody reaches out to each one of these folks and talks to them about the need. We let them know what they can expect and when they can expect it. So we answer any questions that they might have. We create meal boxes, so we'll take cardboard boxes and walk around and place all the items in the box that's appropriate for a Thanksgiving meal. And we've got lots of organizations that reach out to us and want us to provide meals for folks that are in need. It could be a hospital, a veterans group, a food pantry, church organization. We get requests from all over and we try to fulfill those needs.
Agencies come and get the meals and then they distribute. But also we have delivery drivers too that will deliver meals.
There's so many thousands of people out there that don't have food to eat. And if we all pitched in a few dollars, we could help feed the community.
So in case, again, you needed that reminder, it's more than just a fun event tonight with all the dancing. This really is going to a great cause, and every dollar literally makes such a big difference. And our sponsors, they have especially gone above and beyond with some of those big donations. So I want to make sure before we start bringing out the dancers that we take another minute to just acknowledge all of those amazing sponsors, including, of course, our headline sponsor, Infosource. Thank you so much for helping to make this event possible. Year after year, thank you so much for your support. And again, our media sponsor, PSI, thank you again for helping to make such a fun venue and such a fun event happen. Also, a few people might be associated with them. I don't know. And again, all of these tables, not only the ones with the numbers, you notice the people down on the floor, they kind of have that VIP treatment. Those are also some of our table sponsors. So not only did the money donated get you this sweet spot kind of closer to the dance floor, but of course, every dollar that you donated went to your team. So thanks again, everyone who was helping out with that. And of course, every $40 of that, that's actually going toward feeding an entire family a Thanksgiving meal. So hey, let's clap for everyone who's either like bought the ticket for tonight or has those VIP tables. Thanks so much. And of course, because of all of these, it's the biggest event so far this year. So you know, if you've been here the last 2 years, it seems to be actually getting bigger and bigger each time. So thanks so much for everyone who's been making this event so much fun. And one more acknowledgement, want to make sure that we're thanking everyone who's running the cameras, the music, our production team. You guys did such a good job during tech rehearsal. Can't wait to see it in the real thing, too. It's going to be so great. So we've got TechSmart, Mark and Shelley. Hi, Mark. That's Mark. You want to smile at him for the good pictures. And, of course, we also have Ian Alexander Photography, who's running around getting those good pictures, too. And our videographer, we've got Joseph Moore, who's going to be running around judging, making sure video stuff's happening, too. And so, again, let's keep this moving, and let's get to the good stuff. So, okay, before I start to introduce our judges, so you guys are on deck, I want to talk about the awards that you guys are here for. Because, I mean, it is a competition. We get a good show, but we also have those shiny trophies over there. Somebody's got to walk home with them, right? So, you'll also notice on the back page of your program, it kind of breaks it down, but we're looking for things like the Judges' Choice Awards. So that's going to be kind of straightforward. After each dance performance, we have our professional panel, our entertaining panel, letting us know what they thought of the performance. So overall, the best score from the dancing, they're going to end up walking away with an award. The reason we're all here, the fundraising award, that is going to be where we get the big disco ball trophy. That's the award where all of your votes are going toward. And then, of course, everyone who's here in person, you get a vote too. There's going to be a People's Choice Award where you'll be able to cast that free online ballot for your favorite couple. So again, thank you so much for everyone who's been donating so far, but hopefully you're waiting until you see some of the dances so you can really start donating for your favorites. Okay, and the voting process. Again, just sit back, relax, enjoy the show. You have until 9:30 to figure out who you're really gonna be voting for with all of this. And again, $1 that is donated goes to one vote. So you'll be able to also keep track of the tally. We'll check in with the vote tally along the way as well to figure out who's walking away with that mirror ball. And if you're trying to figure out dollar amounts to help out a whole family, each $40 is going to go toward helping an entire family get a Thanksgiving meal. And again, you can go online. We will also have people walking around. And our volunteers, you may have noticed them. They're the ones who are walking around with the fun hats. They also are going to be walking around with the aprons. Those are the people who can also help you out. If you have maybe the cash donations, they're going to be the ones helping you out to collect those. And also in the back, we have a table that's going to be helping to keep track of kind of where everyone is in the scoring process of all of this. And there is also a fourth award. Now, this one is going to be based on the really big donations. So the Frutella Ross Award, that's going to be given to a couple who beats the highest number of funds ever raised. And this is a big number. We're talking about beating $16,653. That was a single team. Yeah, we need to clap for that amount because that was a single team. And remember, we've got 8 couples out there. So we can kind of figure out, do you want to help to get someone that extra award? Are they getting close? Or do you want to help to divide up the wealth? That's going to be one award that we would love to give out tonight. But again, we need your guys' help in order to get that number. Okay, now I know that you guys didn't come here just to watch me in a sparkly dress talking about what's going on. Let's get to the really fun part. Let me introduce you to our wonderful panel of judges. So these are, of course, the people who are going to be in charge of their own award and kind of giving you the real critique on what's going on. And Kimberly Mitchell, you're the first one I want to make sure we're introducing. Now, Kimberly, if you're not familiar, she is a British and American national and Latin dance champion. Woo! Yes! Yay! Yes! And we are so honored to have Kimberly here with us. She is busy all the time traveling across the country, including an early morning flight tomorrow. So one more round of applause for her having the late night tonight, early morning tomorrow to be here. And she judges National Dance Council of America competitions. So again, we are so excited to have you back again this year. One more round of applause for Kimberly. And another one of our judges, Joseph Moore. I didn't. And the sun. Oh. So, one more. Let's give it up for Joseph. Now. And the sunglasses. I didn't realize these are real. Be careful. If he's looking at you with the sunglasses, he's taking pictures. He's recording video. And Joseph, you've probably seen him around from either his conspiracy van or Affirmative Distraction Improv show. So he's bringing the comedy tonight.
That's right.
And he also is not a new face to the Dancing with Our Columbus Stars. He is a returning champion as a past Columbus Dancing with the Stars and a past judge with us too. So welcome back. And we have one more judge to introduce tonight. If you have one of those green VIP vans, you may have already had a chance to meet her. We have Anna Drabunskia. And Anna is not only a dancer, but she's a choreographer, an actress, and a TV personality. And she might look familiar from the real Dancing with the Stars. Thank you so much for joining our local Columbus Dancing with the Stars. I know you have more than 10 years of experience with the big picture show. So hopefully you're enjoying your front row seat. So again, everyone, let's give one more big round of applause for our three wonderful judges. Let's get a practice with the scorecard. How was that applause? Do we need to try again?
I'm gonna give it a 4.
Oh no.
What's happening?
Oh
here?
No.
We're raising money, guys.
Yeah, we're averaging like a 5. One more big round of applause for the judges.
Now
it's better. Getting better. We're getting there. We're in that 8 to 10 range. That's kind of the sweet spot. Glad to know the cue cards are working too for those numbers. Okay, now I'll really get to the part that most of you guys have been excited for. Let's get to the dancing. And again, there's going to be 8 couples out here tonight who have been working so hard to make sure they're putting on a good show and helping to raise money for tonight. And I want to make sure that we are welcoming to the stage our first couple. We have Mandy and Aaron, who will be dancing for us first. And Mandy is an information service leader for Nationwide Children's Hospital. And she is so thrilled to be dancing with us this year. She serves the Columbus community in many ways, so this is just one more that she's able to add to the list. And her professional partner, Aaron, he's a dancer with the Crystal Ballroom, and this will be Aaron's second year joining us. And before they make their grand appearance, I want to make sure that we share a fun little quick video about their journey to where they got to where they are, and also the East Coast swing dance that we'll get to see here in a couple minutes.
So Byron Saunders Foundation is something I'm really excited to be a part of. Thanksgiving is such a special holiday for me. It's an entire day dedicated to giving gratitude and thanks. And I think it's really wonderful to celebrate all the blessings that are in your life. So I'm really inspired and happy to be part of something that helps provide Thanksgiving meals to those in need. And so it really has brought me into the foundation and into this event.
What Byron Saunders means to me is that it's all about charity and giving back to the community. So we're looking forward to doing it tonight and showing our best and doing our best out there.
Aaron is an amazing dance partner and an amazing coach. He's taught me things and helped me buy new muscles and I have some things that I didn't even think I had. So I am
really grateful for him showing me all these new moves and helping me become a better dancer.
So one thing I learned about Amanda is that she is a good listener and she is an excellent sport. She wants to do her best. That's all we look for. So it's been a great time working with her. She's very optimistic about how we're gonna do. We're super excited.
I really hope we win People's Choice Award. That would be exciting. It would be a great wedding gift for Aaron and his fiance Kelsey, who are getting married in December. And so we'd love to win for that. And it would just be also great to win to honor our dance mom, Ben, who really also inspired me to join the event. How about that? Yeah.
Hope for us for best performer. Just, we're super excited. Amanda has put in a lot of work and we've done a lot of good stuff. So just vote for us. Thanks.
That front row seat after all. Hi. So let's give it up one more time for Aaron and Mandy. Okay, now Mandy, do you have any dance experience? You warmed up the dance floor. It hasn't even been touched by social dancing yet. How are you feeling after breaking in the dance floor?
It's pretty exciting.
Yes. Now, what was your experience like? How have you enjoyed things to this point?
It's been great. I have new muscles everywhere. Fantastic. Aaron's a great coach and have learned a ton.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Aaron, you've done this event before. What made you want to come back and participate in this organization and this fun night?
I think it's great what they do for the community, just giving back, you know. And also, I love to perform.
Yes.
In your underwear. Oh,
and it was quite the performance, but let's see what our judges think. What did you think about, especially there were a few surprises in there that did not make the dress rehearsal performance. You were a little more clothed during that.
Oh, boy. This was the perfect way to start. You killed it. I loved your lines, I loved the flicks, I loved your musicality, I loved the chemistry between the two of you. You took your pants off, and I'm not really sure. We'll talk about that later. Totally enjoyed it, thank you so much. And those muscles, keep it going, girl. Yay! Good job.
Come get your pants, man. Where are they?
Just keep talking.
I've known you for a while, and this is not how our friendship continues. You do love to perform, and that's what I always love about seeing you on the dance floor. Aaron, you were fantastic tonight. And Mandy, you were amazing. You killed you were with him. You were with him for every step. I love the whole thing. I love I'm a sucker for lip syncing. That was dope. And the way you guys worked the dance floor, again, you warmed it up, and you warmed it up well. Mm-hmm. Great job. Great job.
Wow. I would agree with both of the judges that it was the absolute perfect beginning of the night. I mean, what a great start with a classic song that everybody can relate to. And then to add the sparkles, which we like, okay, the sparkles. And I'm looking and go, oh, that's a West Coast swing step, okay. That's an East Coast swing step, and I actually had some technical comments. But the moment the pens went off, I was like, okay. I forgot all the technical comments. All I have left is the feeling. But it's a positive feeling, and I am just so thrilled for you guys. Keep dancing, Mandy, because you are a star, and you have a wonderful instructor. Congratulations. Well done.
And again, this is Aaron and Mandy. Keep that in mind if you've been trying to figure out who to vote for. Remember, $1, one vote. So Aaron and Mandy, let's give it up for them one more time.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, wait. And the important part. We got to give them a real score. I stole the thunder from the judges already. Let's get to the important part. What kind of review scores do you guys have for them?
My man did the worm. He did the worm.
And she shook her booty.
She shook
as he did the worm. You know what I mean? That was
yes.
the
booty
the
worm.
Booty worm.
That's the name that dance. Booty worm.
Congrats. Beautiful. All right, round of applause. Thank you guys. Yes. So now that we got the dance floor warmed up, let's introduce our second couple. And this is going to be Brittany and Doug. So, Woo! Yeah. Doug Davidson is director of IT at GBQ. He is an experienced leader, an athlete, a dad, and now he even gets to add a dancer to that list. He is joined by his professional partner, Brittany, who recently moved to DC, so it's great to have her back for this fun event. And she always strives to make their lessons a fun and relaxing experience, and they will be joining us here in a minute dancing a tango. But before we get to that dance, let's take a look at their experience getting to where they are.
The Byron Saunders Foundation means to me family. I think the most impressive thing about what I've heard in terms of the impact of the community is we're delivering ingredients. People have that same family experience of cooking dinner together and celebrating whatever grace they have had in the year past.
Basically what it means to me, I'm from a state that is kind of poor and has a pretty severe drug problem. So something that I've always wanted to do is actually go back and like help people. And so I'm really happy that I'm a part of the Byron Saunders Foundation here because give back, even though it's not to West Virginia, it's still, I'm giving back in a way that sort of aligns with that.
I'm blessed that Brittany and I were paired up. She is a dancer, but she's also somebody who loves the outdoors and teaches fitness and kind of let me, the inexperienced ballroom dancer, learn from somebody who connects with me. She also dances with swords.
Not this time.
I said it was an accident. She's also taught me a lot of things about dancing. Tango terms like lente, corte, bobo fat.
That's jangos.
Oh, bobo jangos. But I think her superpower, what I've learned, and I hope we see that tonight, is that she's able to teach a tree trunk how to dance. And so I'm thrilled that we've been partnered, and I look forward to tonight and showing off our talents. We're going to cheat.
I think more of computers and coding. How would you say getting out on a dance floor in front of everybody else is might be a little different than your normal day to day?
Just a little bit different.
Let me see. Did you earn any dad points from being like, hey, check me out, I'm Dancing with the Stars? Yes. See, that's the score that counts, I think. And what has this experience been like between dancing and being involved in this organization?
Well, when I started, I had no balance. I just think it's been really touching, knowing the impact we have. And a lot of you all don't see what's going on in the backstage, behind the scenes. Everybody's supportive of each other, which is really cool. And so thanks for coming to see that. You didn't get to see the bonding we've had, so thanks.
Yeah, such a big part of that. Thank you, everyone. And So I guess this is your first time coming in as the professional, but you made a special appearance last year in the dance. So what has it been like now with this kind of being your second year being involved and even traveling back for the event? What made you want to be involved this year?
Oh my gosh. So I honestly, like, I was really, really hoping to be involved at the end of last year and having my experience working with Amy and Matt, actually officially having like a star. and so this sort of like coincided with the whole moving to Virginia thing. And I was like, no, I am not going to just not do this. it's for a wonderful cause. And I'm like, it's sort of my last hoorah, my last ballroom hoorah in Columbus too, so.
Well, thank you, glad we could be a part of it. And now judges, your guys' turn. What'd you think of the performance?
Wow. Okay, I'm gonna ask the table behind me because they definitely have a lot to say about the performance. So they were so loud that I was trying to concentrate and like really find all the technical details, and I couldn't. They kept distracting me. Good job. No, but honestly, the outfits, you both looked the part. The song, amazing, super powerful, masculine, strong. I saw some Argentine tango. I saw some Paso Doble moves. And what man doesn't love a Paso Doble, right? You get to stomp and be aggressive. And it's a good thing. So I love the aggression. I love the passion. There are a couple of footwork oopsies here and there, but whatever. So good job. You stayed in character. I really enjoyed it. Well done. And you did not drop the girl.
Yeah, I was going to say that. man, I was scared. I was like, oh, no. But you didn't drop her. And Brittany, you made a tree trunk dance. You made a tree trunk dance. I loved it. I would have loved to see one of you chug a beer, whether that's Doug or Brittany. It's Thunderstruck. It has to happen. So that's the tradition. But other than that, it looked like you guys are having fun. You did dress the part. You guys look amazing. Good job.
I think you actually look like a sexy tree trunk.
Oh.
I think, is that a thing? It's a thing. It's a thing now.
It's gotta be a thing.
Your cortes were fabulous. Your Boba Fett frame sucked. You gave it your all from the moment that you stepped onto the floor. You didn't drop her. You gave it everything on the air guitar, and we'll all be meeting you over there to chug a beer later.
Yes.
Congratulations, well done.
And now moment of truth. We gotta give him a score. What are we thinking? Woo, 8-4, thank you guys. And now, let's give it up one more time for Brittany and Doug. Remember, $1, one vote for Brittany and Doug. And up next, we have our third couple. That's going to be Danielle and Cedric. Now, now, Danielle has a passion for movement, but also for helping others. She's currently a personal trainer who is committed to both physical and mental wellness. And Danielle is going to be joined by her professional partner, Cedric. And Cedric danced with us last year, so if you're here last year, he's going to be a familiar face. And we are so excited to have him back. And before we get a look at their cha-cha, we want to show you what this experience and their journey has been like.
It means helping the community. You're doing something that I love, which is dancing. I get to experience this with you, so it's great.
Byron Saunders Foundation means supporting my local community through people who I know face-to-face. Like, I met Brian Holmberg. Networking, and I know that supporting his foundation means supporting the big ripple effect of people here in Columbus. He's very patient, he's very kind, and he is very, so patient again. Like, I've given him many reasons to be patient, but a great teacher.
Yeah, Danielle always comes in with the best attitude. She's taking it seriously. She knows the importance of this event, but also is making sure that she's having fun through the course of it. And treating dance like a bit of a game. This is fantastic.
Yeah. Brute force.
Brute force.
With skill and enthusiasm.
I like it. Yes. Ditto.
Too far. Let's give it up again for Cedric and Danielle. Yay. Now, Danielle, I've had a chance to dance with Cedric before with some West Coast swing. This was a little different, but okay, when you're working with Cedric one-on-one, what's your strategy for keeping him on pace, keeping him in line?
He has to keep me in line.
Oh boy.
I tell so many stories. He's the best, yeah.
And what was it that really made you say yes to being a part of this experience in this organization?
Well, I got to meet Brian Wallenberg in person, and it's hard to say no to him, you know?
Yeah. Right? Yeah, give it up for Brian. Yeah. Thanks, Brian. And Cedric, now that you've had a chance to be involved with Dancing with Our Columbus Stars a couple of times, what's your experience been like? What keeps you coming back, and what keeps you coming back to be involved in the dancing side, too?
It's always fun. It's for a good cause, and it gets people to dance and have fun with it, so it's fantastic.
Oh, excellent. Well, thank you guys. And now, moment of truth, judges, what'd you think?
Cedric. Hi, Cedric. Everybody say hi, Cedric.
Hi, Cedric.
We got it. Yeah, see? Did you have fun out there? Because you Did you have fun out there? Because you look like you were having fun. And every time I talk to you, I'm like, does this guy ever have fun? But you were having fun. It's true. I love you. I'm saying it out of love. But you look, and Danielle, you're beautiful and everything. Cedric, were you having? I'm just kidding. No, the whole thing was it was amazing. It was dare I say sexy. It was sexy.
You could say
it was very good. You guys were in sync the entire time. I loved it. You guys looked like you were having a lot of fun. I absolutely loved it.
So first of all, congratulations on a fantastic routine. I really enjoyed the choreography. I really enjoyed the idea. I love your outfits. A little strip routine right in the middle, too. I was like, where is this going to go? This is a very interesting gala. And we only like the third number in. What's going to happen with like the seventh number?
Welcome to Columbus.
I'm kind of getting the idea here. But besides that, you guys were in sync. I do want to comment a little bit, like, I feel, Danielle, with your enthusiasm and your charisma, you were a little bit, like, back-leading, dare I say? Just a smidge. But you're so beautiful, you're so talented, and just gorgeous to watch. So I understand how a man would be, or anybody actually, would be mesmerized by your sparkly personality. So well done. I really enjoyed it.
I loved the choreography. inside joke.
Wink, wink.
Yeah. Uh-huh. I feel like I need a cigarette or something now after watching that. And we are only the third routine in.
Exactly.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
There were a few moments where you did get off beat, so you were dancing a little bit off time. Yeah, that's a boo. That's a real big boo in my world. But you know what? You danced beautifully. You danced together. You look stunning. And who cares what beat you were on? So, congratulations, well done.
And sounds like there's the consensus. It was a gorgeous dance, it was wonderful. Everyone seemed to enjoy it, but judges, we gotta give them a score. What are we thinking? We got some eights, so give it up for Cedric and Danielle! Yes! And of course, we were telling you guys, remember, $1, one vote. We do have some updates on kind of where we are with the tally of the votes. So again, we're only three performances in. We've got eight total. If you're trying to still figure out, okay, who am I donating to? We might throw up the scoreboard, make sure that you guys kind of have a feel for where everyone is right now. Again, you can check online, but here is the most recent totals. And Colton and Monica, they're getting close to that extra award, too, so keep that in consideration, too. But hey, remember, no one can be counted out. We are still so early on, so if in case you're trying to figure out, okay, who am I voting for? What are the standings? Remember, $1, one vote, $40 not only gets you 40 votes, but you're going to feed a whole family a Thanksgiving meal. So let's give it up for everyone who's been out here donating as well. Thank you guys so much for your support. Okay, now with that being said, we have our fourth performance of the night. We have Myra and Maya, and Myra Hoy was awarded Miss Pennsylvania title back in 1998. And of course, she continues to shine today with her go-giver spirit. She's going to be dancing with award-winning amateur competitor Maya. And Maya is affiliated with Dance Edge and a nonprofit organization called Dance Unite. And before we get to see their wonderful bachata and salsa formation, we want to show you a little bit of a look to how they got to where they are today.
So the Byron Saunders Foundation means community and helping other people in need. I think it's the most beautiful, most authentic thing for another human to do to others. That's wonderful.
I love that they're
they help all these families, and I know I really care about my family.
Maya is a force to be reckoned with. This young lady has accomplished so much in such a short period of time. I cannot wait to see what else she has in her future. It's fun to just watch her dance and shine like the brightest star in the whole universe. So I think she's awesome.
Thank you. Myra's such a hardworking, beautiful person, and she's such a great role model for me as a young woman, but also for all the other young ladies and students at her at Dance Edge. Something that I think is unique about our partnership is that typically in other partnerships, usually they have a male lead, and I think it's nice to be able to show a female leader dancing, and we're really excited to show you what we've come up with.
Girl power. Everything wiggles, including my ears. Watch. Hey!
Your breath, but kind of curious, how was the experience, especially because you did a lot of this kind of solo. Most everyone else had the moment of the light caught your eye or something, you could be like, oh, my partner's leading me, let's figure this out. What was it like doing this solo, and what this whole experience was like for you?
Well, we have a saying in my company that says that you're for yourself but never by yourself, so I knew that we were all that they had my back, so it was all good.
Oh, I love that. And one thing that I don't know if we mentioned yet, all of the pros out here, normally they charge for the lessons. All of these practices came out of their volunteer time to help this out. So especially as one of the pros, what drew you toward this, knowing that part of your normal lesson time was going toward unpaid volunteering, and even tonight coming out to do this performance?
Well, I really... I love to give to the community for people that that can't really like afford to be dancing, and so it's nice to have some extra experience in dancing that can, especially with Myra, it's always fun, and it's going towards a great cause.
Yeah.
And giving back.
I think if we just keep that focus, that this is a giving opportunity, and it just makes everything right. So.
Oh, I love that. Thank you so much. And now, judges, what'd you think of that performance?
Hi.
So you walked out and you stood in the middle, and I thought, oh, can she bring it? Because I know the girls behind you, and I know that the girls can bring it. And you nailed it. From start to finish. There was a music change. You changed the feeling inside of you. I'm just doing it now.
Oh!
No words, just marks.
Wow.
You are awesome. Thank you for doing this on your own and with the girls. Thank you. Thank you.
Can I cuss here? Can I?
No, there's children in the house.
There's children?
There's, yes.
They're five? So they probably
there's
heard
some
worse.
Really young.
Okay, cool. Holy shit. That, y'all, listen. We've doing this, what, 4 or 5 years? I've been doing this 4 or 5. I've never seen anything like that. Ever. And you stayed in step with everybody. Y'all, I don't know why y'all over. Why y'all over there?
Exactly. Come
get,
on.
Get out here.
Come
get
on.
Out
get
here.
Back out here. Get, come on.
Get your flowers.
It's a whole team effort.
Get your flowers. I don't know if there was some Sasha Fierce in there, some Beyonce formation.
Yeah.
But I saw it, and it was great. And I'm gonna do the same thing right now. I'm gonna do the same. Y'all can be mad if y'all want to, but look, that was fantastic. All the way through. Thank you. Good job.
Wow. I mean, first of all, young ladies, you are all stunning. You're beautiful. You're very talented. Keep doing what you're doing. However, Miss Myra, with your life experience and fierceness, and you came out and you're like, I'm bringing it. And I think there's a few things that you could actually teach to these girls yourself. Mm-hmm. So don't quit dancing. Don't stop dancing just because the event is over. I completely agree with these guys. It is so much more challenging to be solo, dance everything for whole 2 minutes by yourself than have a partner, right? Because you have to be your own boss. You have to be completely responsible for everything you do. You should be with your partner anyway. But there's nobody to like kind of give you a nudge. Oh, we're going that way. So, and you were right front and center. So even though they were behind you, I mean, in the way, you were the Rihanna and Beyonce and, you know, all of those girls right front and center. And what an amazing job. All of you, congratulations. And I'm doing it too. We all do.
There we have it, our first perfect 10. So let's give it up one more time. Congratulations, guys. Beautiful performance. And now that we're at the halfway point, again, you've heard a whole lot about like, hey, $1, one vote. Keep that in mind. Now that we have our first perfect 10, we've had a whole lot of creative outfit changes in the middle of some of the performances, keeping things spicy. And of course, I want to remind you as well, again, of the reason that we are all here. And for that, we have another video to kind of show you and remind you really the purpose of what Byron Sanders Foundation is all about.
The Byron Saunders Foundation's mission is to provide Thanksgiving meals to families in need. Your reason for needing a meal this year could be because you're out of work, or it could be because you have medical issues. We don't care what the reason is. If you think that you need help, we're here to help you. One box typically will feed a family of four, but you could be a family of 16. If you tell us that you have 16 people that you need to feed, we're going to provide you enough boxes that will feed all 16. We create meal boxes. So we'll take cardboard boxes and walk around and place all the items in the box that's appropriate for a Thanksgiving meal. And we've got lots of organizations that reach out to us and want us to provide meals for folks that are in need. It could be a hospital, a veterans group, a food pantry, church organization. We get requests from all over and we try to fulfill those needs.
We have lost all of our major food drives this year, and we just couldn't do it on our own. We could not do it without this help.
Most of these people wouldn't even have a Thanksgiving without getting a meal from us. And one guy that I called, he goes, I would come through that phone and kiss you right now if I could. He said, it's been such a rough year and this is just a blessing.
They were trying to survive with rent and just transportation and food sometimes, and especially a nice meal is hard to come by. So I think this will make a huge difference for those 25 families that will receive this.
There are so many needy people, especially this year. They've reached out to me like in August and September asking if the box is going to be available.
We appreciate everything that we get here, all the food that's provided, and the support from the staff is awesome. The Byron Saunders Foundation does an outstanding job supporting us.
Foundations like this foundation and groups like I Am Church partnering together is very important if we really want to make change and make a bigger impact.
100% of the donations that are made to this organization go back to our recipients.
One of the easiest ways to give is to support us in monthly giving. With your support, we can feed families, more families in Franklin County, but also surrounding counties.
The feeling that you get when you give is pretty tremendous. And when you sit down at your Thanksgiving table and you realize that you gave a little more than you probably felt like you had to give, and you think about all of the people that you fed that year for Thanksgiving, that you want to do it every single year again and again.
And I know so many people in this room have been a part of the different volunteer efforts, and I've had a chance to even go out on one of the days where we're boxing up the food, giving it to the organizations. And I think before I got involved with this, I always kind of wondered, okay, I know you can go to a church or a food pantry and then you get the food and it goes to the family. But I always kind of wondered where that came from. I knew it had to start somewhere. And I think it's amazing that this is a foundation that is finding the people, like everyone in this room, who wants to make a difference in their community, who are thinking, you know what? Spending holidays with family and having that meal is so important to me, and I'd like to share it with someone else. This is the organization that makes sure that when someone goes to that church and says, I don't know how I'm going to feed my family for Thanksgiving, they're providing that church that meal so that they can do that. And having an opportunity to even go out and volunteer to put the food in the boxes to pass out to different community members, it's been amazing to see how Columbus as a whole comes together to help each other out. So no matter what level you're able to give or volunteer, it is so amazing to be a part of the city and such a great organization that is just continuing to take care of each other. And of course, the biggest way, and probably the reason that a lot of us are here today, is trying to figure out how we can give back, how we can help that, how we can make sure that if it's a year where someone is just really struggling, that we can make sure that Thanksgiving is great for them. And we keep mentioning it, one of the best ways you can do is vote for your friends, vote for that favorite performance. There's even the QR code. If you look through the performers, you can give that dollar per vote, $40 for a whole meal for a family for Thanksgiving. And also, we still have things like the 50-50 raffle going around, so make sure that you are donating to that. We have the silent auction items. All of those donation items and opportunities go on until 9:30. And so thank you again for everyone who's been out here. So one more round of applause just for the foundation, for everyone and all the moving parts that go into this. Thank you so much, everyone, for coming out and participating in this. And another reason that I got involved was I happened to, 2 years ago, have an opportunity to come out and dance with Colton Hutton. Thank you again for everyone who is even in this room, my parents included, who came out to the event, voted, helped us out. Not gonna brag, but we may have gotten perfect 10s at the event, so. thank you to our wonderful judges as well. That was one thing that helped to spark not only being new to a town, an organization to get involved in for me personally, but helped to kind of re-spark a love for dancing, especially because during 2020, we were in a pandemic. We were trying to figure out how to keep sanity in some way. So this has been a great opportunity for that as well. And of course, one of the reasons that I wanted to make sure that I gave Colton the shout out was, you know, there's this rowdy area over here who might be associated with, like, the dancer who's on deck. Yes! So, that being said, our fifth performance of the night is going to be Monica and Colton. So, Monica is the co-owner and chief client officer for Columbus-based technology firm. You may have heard mentioned a couple times, PSI. And now Monica, she has a flair for life and a flair in her heart for dancing as well. And she is paired this year with professional dance partner Colton Hutton. And for years, yeah, give it up for both of them. For years now, Colton has been able to empower people to feel more beautiful and confident through dance. And I also mentioned I got to be with him for his first performance with the Dancing with Our Columbus Stars. And this will be his retirement performance for the event. And I know! It's okay, he's giving someone else the opportunity. We're sharing the wealth. And now that being said, they will be joining us here in a minute with their dance medley. But first, let's take a look at their journey.
So Monica, what does the Byron Saunders Foundation mean to you?
You know, Colton, that is a wonderful question. The Byron Saunders Foundation, to me, is a wonderful organization that just focuses on feeding a lot of Central Ohio families Thanksgiving meal.
The Byron Saunders Foundation is amazing because most people don't know that organizations don't take all of the proceeds, all of the donations that they get, and put them back into people. Every single person is a volunteer, so every single dollar that you provide counts 100% to feeding a family.
And especially that we can give back to our own community. So it's taking all of these dollars that you're buying to make us win, because we've been working really hard, but all of those votes, all of those proceeds are going to feed our own community. So it's a way that you can give back. You are here today eating and enjoying and having a great time, but not everybody gets this. So the mission that we get to dance for and that you are getting to be here for tonight is to help realize to other people that they can enjoy great Thanksgiving meals with their families.
Nom nom.
Mm-hmm. Mm. I can't cuss because I'm a lady.
Yeah.
And this is for charity.
And I'm too to cuss either.
But you're going down.
Whoa.
You're going down. All of you. I've been dancing my butt off.
Literally, she's doing amazing.
That's right. You heard that.
She's going to kick down. The butt.
You're going down.
All the down.
The mirror ball. It's ours.
It's ours.
It's
all
not yours.
All million squares.
It's not yours.
All of them.
It's mine. It's his. We're going down.
Yes.
We love you. Go charity.
Go charity.
Take a chance on love.
Way to go! Now, yes. Not only were you having to learn a dance, but you know, you brought a couple people with you. What's it like getting in front of everyone for this?
It's amazing. I love everybody here, and we made that dress. My friend and I, we made both dresses, so it's amazing.
That's so impressive. Made it even more incredible. And now, Colton, third time doing this. How? I'm sure each experience is different. I was a little jealous, not gonna lie, but what is it that got you coming back each year? And I've noticed you guys, you know, raised a little more money than what we did. So how does it feel close to that coveted award for raising over 16K?
It feels amazing, absolutely amazing.
And thank you guys so much. Also, wanna give you the reminder that the record amount raised for this event. So in order to get that Frutell Ross Award, the one that we're like, we'd like to give it away, but we gotta see. So the number to be for that, 16,653. Back there, is there a way that we can check on the numbers? Just have it back there to see how close we are? So, I mean, we're close. We're really close.
Yeah, runs up there.
So, that being said, also, another word that's on the table is seeing what the judges think. So, judges, what are you thinking after this performance?
I'm going to cuss again. I'm just kidding. Wow. Just, wow. So, being in the band, the I Wanna Dance with Somebody, it started off with the slow, and then you gave like a little hint. I was like, oh, they're gonna do it, and then the song kept going, and you gave another little hint. I was like, oh, they're gonna do it, and then you did it, and I was like, oh, they did it. From start to finish, it was amazing, way better than Liz's dance. That's a personal thing because he's a Kansas City Chiefs fan and I've been waiting all night.
Wait, we gotta do that.
We have a rivalry.
It's football season.
She beat the 49ers in the foot. Anyway, Brian Wallenberg's a 49ers fan, by the way, so there's that. Back to you guys. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to take that from you. And you said you was gonna bring it. No, step out there, walk your walk,
yeah.
Talk your
One
talk. Because you said you was gonna come out there and do it and you did it. I don't know who led who. I don't know who choreographed what, but it was amazing. I'm gonna keep talking to y'all because it was hands down. All right, done.
You want me? Woo! I'll go.
Okay.
Go. So I need to stretch my jaw. I was smiling so much, I can't even talk.
I just love how it started out really slow. I'm like, ooh, she's struggling with the music. I'm like, ooh, that point. I'm like, oh, I can get with that. And then you change dances again. I'm like, ooh, the girls learned two dances. Okay. Oop, yep, whoop, whoop. And then you change dances again. And then I'm thinking, oh, I can see a Spanx. And then the dress came off. And the short one came down like, ooh, I love you, okay, my kind of girl. And then you kept going and like Sunshine in the Middle said, you did it. Hustle is definitely your dance. So you have a stunning point to your toes. It's a thing. And you have beautiful hands. I mean, you have a beautiful face. You have beautiful hands. And I loved every minute of this dance. Congratulations, well done.
It was so packed with so many things. I mean, the pointing, the teasing, the seducing, the heel leads, the pointing of the toes, then the undressing came in, then the Spanx, then the bra line and all of this.
Yes.
And I'm like, I don't even know what to focus on anymore. And the hair. And the backbends. I mean, this routine was so packed with A, stuff choreographically, but also musically. It was jam-packed. It was all of these transitions and changes with musically, right?
Which yes.
The musician in the house talks about. Because it is actually quite challenging, even for a professional dancer, right, Colton, wouldn't you say? And the fact that you were able to stay on time, on tune, and in the character for both of these changes, for both of the dances, is not an easy feat, even for a pro. So, Monica, oh my gosh. Amazing. Amazing. You guys did so good. There are a couple of little something, 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 little there and there, little balance. But you know what? Whatever. It's the nerves. We're going to say it's the nerves.
The nerves.
But overall, beautiful. Really fantastic.
Let's give it up one more time for Monica and Colton.
Are we doing
and
doing it?
One more. We got to get a score from everybody. Woo! 9s and 10s! And again, they're up for that very hard-to-reach fundraising goal of over $16,000. So there could be an extra award in their future, too, depending on how many more votes they get. So thank you, everyone, for coming out and putting in those votes. And one more time, give it up for Monica and Colton. Thank you, guys.
That was good that you did that, too. That was good.
Man.
Good job.
And now on deck, we have our sixth couple. That's going to be Audrey and Rostislav. Now, Audrey flows from project manager to, I tried really hard. You're going to have to help me with the last name. Audrey flows from project manager to percussionist and is always on a mission to immerse herself in the arts. And she is so thrilled to have a chance to dance with us tonight. She is going to be dancing with her partner, Ross, whose passion is to be connected and move better. So before we see their Viennese waltz, I want to take a minute to look at their journey dancing.
Ross has been such an amazing teacher. As some of you might know, I refer to him as Mr. Miyagi or Bon Miyagi, right? Because for probably about 50%, if not more, time we've spent together, he made sure I got to understand the basics and finding my balance. He is not joking when he said that he had to start from ground zero, and even more so because there was some unlearning to do there as well. I went from not being able to walk in a straight line on the dance floor to now being able to put on the show you're about to see.
Starting out, we set out the role and we set out the bar. The bar was quite high because I said right from the get-go that I want this to be a good performance, not because somebody decided it's to be good, but we should decide that that's going to be good for us and we're going to be happy with what we've done. I'm very grateful that she was my partner and I really got to learn a lot from you as well. I learned about myself, I learned about you, and I hope you guys can see this connection when we dance.
Yeah, I don't think they could have paired a more perfect set, though. We're both big nerds in our own ways, and it's been really neat to see what makes him, what he's passionate about, and I think that he's gotten to see what I'm passionate about as well, and that shared passion translates into our practice and our performance.
Yeah. So I'll see you guys very shortly.
I'll fight tonight. I'll call you after my blood is drowning in alcohol. No, I just wanna hold ya. Give a little time to me. We'll burn this out. We'll play hide and seek to turn this around. All I want is the taste that your lips allow. My, my, my.
The tens. How you feeling after the performance? Have you had a chance to catch your breath, especially since you have an audience here?
Yeah, I feel like I already won. I mean, I feel great. I'm so glad I got to show you guys what I've been working on for months with Ross here and for such a great cause. So glad I have so many friends and family here to support me and all of the new friends I made while on this journey. I can't thank you guys enough.
And Ross, what was it that makes you want to come and be involved in this organization and volunteer your time for this and put all of that passion into a dance like what you guys just performed?
Are you inviting me for the second time? No. I really appreciate it. As I was saying before, I think great tradition takes time to develop. And Brian Sanders has been doing it for over 20 years. I think it's a great thing that we all can take part of it this evening, before and after. And thank you guys for all. Without you, it wouldn't be happening. Thank you.
And now, judges, what do you think of the performance?
Well, I'm just going to give you the props for having a vulnerability to do a routine like that. That is really, yes, Rostislav, well done. Yes, you put that girl through some interesting experiences there. To do a routine that is kind of bewitching and enigmatic, it's quite challenging for a beginner, actually. And looking at you, I can't even say that you're a beginner. I mean, you have the hair, you have the sparkles, you have the eyelashes. I mean, you looked the part, you felt the part. You danced very well. And I think you were able to do and translate through your movement and through your dancing the idea of the piece. I mean, you were bewitching him. He was laying on the floor. You were like teasing him, but all done in the very, very, very witchy, enigmatic, cosmic way. So I truly enjoyed it. Let's just say it was great. Yep.
So these are the type of dances that make me respect this craft. Like, no, seriously, I want more. Where's the lady who was yelling over? Yes, there you go. It was beautiful. And on what she said, it looked like you guys were both pros out there. It's something that I don't ever think I would get to that level, right? And it was that beautiful to where everybody was just like, wow, you know? It was breathtaking. I loved it. It was mesmerizing. Loved it. No jokes. For real.
I know. It's my turn. I think Anna had some wonderful words to say about the choreography and the feeling, and I was going to come out and say it was a very feely dance. It was very touching. It was very dramatic. And for those of you that do know me, I wanted more drama.
Yeah. Yep. Yep.
My table over there.
Yep.
Yeah. The moment where you were walking around him and bewitching him and you had this beautiful smile on your face because you enjoyed every single moment that you stepped foot on the floor and you gave it your all. And I loved that about you. I think you look like a ballroom dancer. You danced like a ballroom dancer. And now I want more drama. And maybe those flowers.
Excellent.
Okay.
So, to add to the drama, judges, what are we thinking? Got 8s and 9s. Great job, guys. Yes. And of course, we have a whole table of 10s over there, too. So, so let's give it up one more time for Ross and Audrey.
Who's booing?
Wait a minute.
We don't care.
Wait a minute, Liz. Hold on. Who's booing? You booing me? You booing us? How dare you? How dare you?
Table 15, get them all drinks.
Yep, get them all drinks. Table 15.
Calling table 15
are the
drinks.
Ones that are throwing things at people on the dance floor. Could we not do that? Okay, I'm sorry, Liz. You may.
Oh, no, keep going, please.
No.
Okay, my turn. Okay, so our next couple, we are going to be bringing out Brandy and Kyle. Now, Brandy is... Yeah, get up for him! She is an instructional designer for DaVita Kidney Care and has a heart for service, both professionally and personally. And she's going to be joined by her professional partner, Kyle, who readily came on board for this experience and is excited to have a chance to get involved and a chance to give back as well. They'll be dancing a West Coast swing, but hey, like with the last couple of couples, let's make sure that we get a look at their journey before we see that dance.
I love the Byron Saunders Foundation. I met Brian Nolan a few years ago, and just his spirit of giving and selflessness really drew me to him. And Thanksgiving is more about just getting food on the table. It's about dignity and having a sense of normalcy and maybe what's currently a chaotic world in life and crazy things.
I may not know as close as Brandy does, but it's definitely an opportunity to give back to the community through dance, which is something I've always loved to do, and it's something that I think is part of why I guess we do what we do. I'm not excited.
Kyle is amazing. He's been so patient and just has this special ability to break down the mechanics of the dance moves in a way that I understand, that I can break it down on my own and then practice and hopefully get better. And then he's awesome because he's amazing analogies, like from strawberries to like my son and it being an angry mom. Like, it's the whole
thing. There's like been wonderful working with you. You bring so much to the table. Like it's rare to run into somebody that has so much enthusiasm and passion at the same time you feel the effort putting the effort into it. So it's constantly like reevaluating what I'm planning to do. Like, if we can do this, maybe we can't. And then you're like, yeah, we can do it. I want more. It's like, oh, okay, back to the drawing board. Very refreshing. I love it.
Your skill.
I like to think, like, I don't know, like, hard work. I think we put a lot of time into this. Hard work, effort, practice. But no, and then, of course, like, the support of everybody out there.
Last night was shit, my phone was dark, the world's a mess, that's just the start, but I slept alright, I guess it's good morning. Phone call from mom, dad lost his job, text from my ex, she's moving on, but we're all alive, it must be good morning.
Lying beds and mistakes, swim around in this bed that I made, know the past doesn't change.
But we're pushing past it today, so
get up!
Make some coffee, make some love. Take a shower, do whatever,
just get up!
Cause the sun ain't gonna stop. If you're ready, if you're not,
just get up!
Today is all we got, tomorrow might not come.
So get up!
Get up!
Good morning!
Yeah. Throw on a shirt, the same old jeans. I swear my veins, they're never clean, but I'm feeling new, cause it's a good morning. Look, it might be the day when nothing's right, might be the day that changes my whole life. You never know, they both start with good morning. Oh, nightmares and mistakes, swim around in this bed that I made. I know the past doesn't change, but we're pushing past it today.
So get up!
Got me into partner dancing. There's a lot of directions you can go with it. What made you get to the point where you're like, yes, something like this, and also please pick me up and just twirl me around?
I mean, what other way is there to do it, right? Kyle's amazing.
And what is the whole experience from not only the dancing to the fundraising part? What's that been like for you to just be involved with this?
It has been the best. The community coming together and learning new skills with Kyle and making new friends. It's just been all around amazing.
And Kyle, question two about like what's the whole experience been like being involved with the organization? At what point were you like, you know what? Let's crank this up another level. I think you got what it takes. Let me pick you up, see how it goes.
Well, it's been an absolute blast. I was here a few years ago as a spectator. So when Katie reached out to me to participate this year, I jumped the opportunity. And two, really it's Brandy showing up every day and I'm always pre-planning what we're going to be doing and coming like, well, should we do this, A, kind of something challenging, B, maybe a little bit easier. And she's like, I want the hard thing. Give me the hardest thing. And then she'd just rock it. So, yeah, like gives the proof was in the pudding.
Oh, well, perfect. Well, it was definitely fun to watch, but judges, what do you guys think? Yeah, wait, pause. Let's give them another round of applause.
Hi, my love. He saved you, and you kept going, you didn't let it faze you, you came down beautifully, you sold it, and for that I applaud you. What I'd like to say is you're way more ballsy than I am because I like one foot on the floor at all times. You would not get me up in the air like that, so. I think this dress needs a trip to Kroger or something after this event because you look stunning in silver.
Yeah.
So maybe cleaning the house or, you know, at work, around the gym. West Coast Swing is such a slow, feely musical dance, and it's super difficult when the music is super duper slow. And I feel that you worked well together. You found the connection. And please keep dancing. Yay. You did great.
So you weren't going to lift him up?
I thought, that's next year.
I thought that was... I got to dock you a point because I thought that was going to happen. So that was disappointing. No. I love the song selection. I love what you guys, you guys went out there, you go out there, you have fun. It matters not, right? You're raising money for a good cause, and I loved every bit of it. So you look like you were having a blast. So, and you know, you got the perfect partner to do that because this guy is, you know, he's too much all the time. So congratulations. Great job. Great job.
I think I found the part of your dress. No, it's okay. You do look stunning. I agree with Kimberly that silver is absolutely your color. You looked like you were having so much fun, that you were having a blast, that gorgeous smile. I mean, the legs, the lift. Let me just say, this is the first lift of the night. And unlike Carrie Ann and Ava on Dancing with the Stars, I'm going to say, yeah! I love it. I love lift work. And it wasn't one. It was actually three, right? Three lifts. So it's not an easy thing to do, but you have the perfect partner for it. West Coast Swing is such a chill, and it could go many different directions. It could have been like the sexy West Coast Swing. It could be bluesy West Coast Swing. Could be country West Coast Swing. And you chose a very fun, positive, encouraging songs. And I think it reflects who you two are. And that's what you brought to this competition, to this event. So get up. And having you all the way there, I was like, yes, amazing. Beautiful, beautifully danced.
Do the lift again. Do the lift again.
Do the lift again.
Do it again.
Do it again.
Do the lift again.
Do the lift again.
Oh, wait. Are you really going to do it? You're going to do it?
Do it.
Oh, no. We don't have it. We don't have insurance.
Ooh. Ready,
do
set,
it.
Go. Woo!
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Yes.
Wow.
See, I would have dropped you. I would have. That would have definitely...
I totally makes me want to go up there and be like, can you lift me now?
Yeah, see?
I want to be now lifted.
There's going to be a line at the bar with like, me next. Lift me, bro. Come on, bro.
New reason for the green VIP bracelets.
There you go. That's right.
Okay, judges. That was some great feedback, but we got to give them a score. What are you thinking?
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Woo! We got a bunch of A's out there. Thank you so much. Give Brandon and Kyle one more round of applause. Thank you so much, guys.
I had it at 9 for the extra lift. So
yeah.
I don't think that's cheating.
And now, if you've been keeping track, we're up to dancer number 8, so... yeah. Who may or may not have a few fans in the audience already. So, of course, last but not least, we want to make sure we are welcoming Ron and Kristen out to the stage. And you might be thinking to yourself, Ron Stokes, okay, why does that sound familiar? Well, oh yeah, it might be your uncle, that's a reason. He's also an entrepreneur. But also, the reason that a lot of people here in Columbus might know the name is he is also a very accomplished athlete. He was a member of Ohio State's men's basketball team. And also, it feels almost sinful that we're in Columbus. Yes, one more time, OH! While he was playing with the big OHIO, he earned an all Big Ten honors and was also the team's MVP. And he will be dancing with his professional partner, Kirsten, who has been not only his cheerleader, but the coach through this experience. So let's take a look at the video to see how they got to where they are.
Foundation means a whole lot to me because raising money for people in need is so necessary, and sometimes we can become forgetful of those that are a little less fortunate and could use some extra help, especially around the holidays. One of the things that I did earlier on the last couple of years, especially during COVID, is help out at one of the local food pantries, and it just, seeing those in need sometimes makes you a little more grateful for the things that we have that we can take for granted at times.
Oh, Kirsten, that's great. When I first found out about the foundation and decided to participate there with the STARS, helping the homeless and the needy get home with me, because back in my hometown, it's a group of former athletes from Canton, Ohio. We put together a group that feeds over 1,000 families every single December. So when I heard about what this fund is doing, purely excited about that. And like Kirsten said, anytime you can help the unfortunate, someone that's not doing as well as you, how can you go wrong with doing that? So this is all for a great cause. We're very excited about participating.
I've had the joy of working with Ron this last couple of months, and it has been so awesome to see where he started and then where he's come in such a short amount of time. You can tell he just is very hardworking. He practices, and it's very obvious even as he comes and goes. And then one of my favorite things about Ron is just how personable he is to everyone who comes into the studio. He immediately introduces himself to them and welcome as well.
Yep, that's awesome. And what can I say about Kirsten? I just learned to respect another profession very well, much more. Obviously, when you watch Dancing with the Stars on TV, you see people out perform, especially the professionals, you kind of take it for granted a little bit, but it goes, a lot of work goes into doing what they do. And she's been a fantastic teacher. Definitely had to have a lot of patience with me, because I started from scratch. I'm not really as much of a dancer, but she really helped me and gets me to this point, and I really enjoyed working with her. Hey, look at my shirt, Buckeyes for Life. For you Buckeye fans out there, you got a vote for me, Kirsten, Kirsten and Ron. Come on now, Buckeyes, come on. Vote for us.
OH.
I-O.
In the sun,
should I go for this? You better shake.
Should I take the ball down the middle, then I shoot the shot? I move fast when I dribble, watch out for the block. I lose focus when I think of a name. I gotta get my head in the game. Does she think about me? Does she feel the same way? Should I shoot for a three? Gotta stay in game play. I think I'm going insane. Can't get her out of my brain.
Gotta get your head in the game. Gotta.
Columbus, enjoy Ohio State, enjoy sports. So, do you have any dance experience? Was this something completely new and different for you?
No, Wallflower back in the day, but you know, my mom loves Dancing with the Stars. So when they asked me to do it, I first sent the first video of me doing it, she says, "Ronnie, you got to move your hips more." Right? So, but it's been a blast. Kirsten's been awesome, and. Out of my element, but I had a great time, and obviously for a great reason tonight.
And Kirsten, what do you think? How did you help to like loosen up, make sure he was ready for the big performance in front of like the harsh audience over there?
Well, you could tell he practiced at home. He took the critiques and he'd practice with his headphones, he said, back at home, and you could tell coming back each week was awesome.
Okay. And then, yes, and for both of you, it's also a big fundraising event. How I was just knowing that you have the full circle of putting in the time to make sure that you have the performance, but also knowing it's going to something bigger than just the time commitment.
Oh, no question about it. Just my coaches taught me this, my mom and dad pay it forward, so I'm in a position to help others, so I'm doing it.
That was great. And now, judges, what are you thinking?
It's a little pandering on the offense. Amen. Hey, first of all, we out here, y'all. We out here, right? Yeah. Sir, that was completely unexpected. And I loved it, every bit of it. Kirsten, you made him a star. You made him a star. No, everything about it, man. It was. You said you were a wallflower, yep. But you went to Ohio State. Lies. Lies. I loved every bit of it, man. It looked like you were having a lot of fun out there, and we talked earlier, and I told you to get your head in the game. Had no idea that was your song. No idea. I was like, bro, keep your head in the game, and then you came out, and he was like, keep your head in the game. I was like. Pandering. But no, you look like you had a lot of fun. Y'all had a lot of fun. Good job. Thank you.
Yay! You want me to go? I'll go on the YouTube. Yeah.
So if that song comes on again, are you going to run and hide or are you going to do the routine? That's what I want to know. For someone that can't dance, I think you did an awesome job. Your timing was a little bit suspect. Yeah, you can all boo me, but here we go. I think you did, I hate to say it, but your mother's right. You needed to move your hips some more.
Baby, you need to move your hips now. That's how you say it? Baby?
She's nodding.
Move them hips now. What are you doing?
I think you did an awesome job. You covered the floor. You had props, which is really difficult when you're dancing, and especially for a beginner to... It's not the first time you've handled a ball, but whilst you're moving your feet and your hips, clearly that was a little difficult. Congratulations. The smile had it for me. Thank you.
Wow. I mean, yes. This wasn't just a dance performance. This was an entertainment, okay? It was the game. It was the cheerleading. I do appreciate you not wearing the shorts and actually wearing the pants and slacks and proper dance shoes. Nope. I know you probably, your instinct was like, I want to wear tennis shoes. And she's like, no. But can I wear that? No, you're wearing the proper Latin heels. So I respect to you for dancing in those shoes, because I know this is not the most comfortable thing ever. But like Kimberly mentioned, having props, and not just props at the beginning of the routine, but props that came in and out, and you had to catch the ball and then go straight into cha-cha and then catch the girl and then go throw the ball and then catch the ball. I mean, it was like watching like a music video to that song. It was, seriously, it's like a music video. Let's put it on the YouTube and make it viral. What do you think about that?
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, Yana, say OH. Say it. Say
OH? OH?
There you go. Say it again.
OH!
She's never done it before, guys.
Oh, I've never done it before.
She didn't know what it was.
I didn't, no clue. Oh, yeah. But congratulations. I loved every single bit of it. The being on time here and there, you know what? You were on your own time and you were in the game and you were in the zone, and that's what matters. And the smile was going on and you were always entertaining and inspiring on so many levels. So congratulations, guys.
So ladies and gentlemen, if you remember in the beginning, there is a People's Choice Award.
There is.
And if you didn't like what we had to say and our marks, now is the time to place your votes and make them count. Yeah. You know how to do it. If you don't, get somebody that does and place your vote.
Ron. Ron.
Oh, Ron, look.
Ron, look.
He was like way down.
Weren't you fourth when you came in?
Oh, Ron.
Weren't you fourth?
People like you.
You were third when you came in?
He can make.
Yep.
My boy making money.
Moving up.
Moving up. Boy making money.
Hello, look at that. 18.
Look at those numbers.
Almost 19.
Oh, we gotta do the numbers.
Oh, yeah, we do.
I got it. Okay. I was getting carried away with my...
We out here.
Oh, yeah, let's show the score real fast. You.
We out here.
We doing it.
Oh, okay. What's your thing? We out here.
There you go, 9 and 10s.
It's the last one.
Oh, yes. Beautiful job. And let's give it up for Ron and Kirsten one more time.
I'm really mad about that. Fair enough. I don't give a
shit. And we're just looking at the tally, so hopefully you are taking notes. Also, taking note of the reminder that you guys have power in one of the awards, too. By showing up tonight, not only are you contributing to a fun event, a great organization, but you get a chance to vote for your own favorite along the way, too. So we are going to take a little break here in a minute, but wanted to give you a couple of reminders that all of the voting stays open until 9:30, so... Let me see. We got another solid 15 minutes for you to text your friends, say, hey, we got time to donate. We want to make sure our friends are pulling ahead. On top of that, silent auction is over there. Of course, we got the cash bar. And we will be wrapping up and closing voting at 9:30. And then we'll be back to announce award winners at 9:45. So let's give it up for our judges and everyone who just danced one more time. Yay, we'll see you guys at 9:45. Keep voting. Now, we've had a group in the back alongside all of our volunteers kind of trying to calculate the money raised, helping out with the 50-50 raffles, helping out with all of that. So let's give a big round of applause for all of the volunteers who have been helping to really crunch these numbers.
And a lot of the numbers still kind of being calculated from the event as a whole, but it sounds like we're approaching $80,000 that have been raised from this event. And so much of that has been coming from everyone sitting in this room, everyone who danced on stage tonight. Thank you again so much for all of the hard work that you guys have been putting in. And looks like next on the list are a couple of awards that we got to get to. So let's start with, hey, everybody in the room, the People's Choice Award. So this, of course, came from everyone who came here and voted tonight. So please give it up for Monica and Colton!
Perfect!
And of course, it wasn't just you guys who had a chance to vote. We really liked hearing all the votes, seeing how you guys kind of thought it played out as far as the dancing went. But of course, our judges also had a say in one of the awards. So I think it's probably no surprise. Goes to the group that got straight tens. So give it up for Maya and Myra. Beautiful job, girls. And also, I mean, we saw some of the numbers. Everyone did such a great job, not only with their dances, but with fundraising. And this is an incredible number that came in from this one. So, the big sparkly trophy for the top fundraiser, it goes to Monica and Colton, and get this. They raised an outstanding $22,781. You guys did such a great job getting the word out, making sure families have a meal on Thanksgiving. Thank you so much for everyone who has been donating. And of course, you may have noticed there was like a big number that we were keeping track of to make sure that they could get that Fruitel Ross Award. I mean, they only had, you know, a measly $16,653 as a pair to try to fundraise. So you guys helped so much, and everyone in this room helped so much to raise not only that, what, 80,000 plus that is going toward the Byron Saunders Foundation tonight, but over $22,000 raised by you guys and from everyone in this room. So thank you again. So that, of course, means that you have a very special award coming your way. It looks like you've run out of hands to hold everything. So since your hands are full, we'll let you know you are getting one more award heading your way. And it's going to be an award that is going to have the special engraving with this number, which again, we got to make sure that they can, there's enough room on there to put not only both their names, but that over $22,000 that you guys have raised. So that has been so amazing, and thank you again, everyone, so much for coming out. Let's give it up one more time for all of our dancers. And you guys not only got to vote and help one of our pairs become a winner, but there also were some 50-50 raffles, some silent auction winners. So let me see. I may need to grab someone for this one. Do we have official names for people who have been winning prizes? Do we know where Katie is? So, where's Katie at? Sorry, I need your help.
Making this happen. Ooh.
You know what? We will make sure that we are contacting all the winners for the things like the 50-50 raffles, the silent auctions. And I think that we are all just overwhelmed by all of the hard work that you guys have been putting in. You have been working several months for these dances. It has paid off. I feel like everyone had the love in the room supporting you. And so just one more time, let's give it up for all the fundraising that happened tonight, all these beautiful dancers. Yeah, everyone step forward, take a big bow. Now, make sure that you're finding them because we're going to open up the dance floor and it's going to be open dancing. And now that you have seen the skills from everyone out on this dance floor, I expect you guys to keep it packed all night long. Reminder, cash bar's over there.
And we're grabbing the winners right now. We're going to create a little suspense and pull our 50-50 raffle winners. Annette, are we doing this like in real time? Are we drawing in real time? We're ready? Let's do it. Let's do it.
Bring it on up here. The moment that everyone who's been like looking at your ticket has been waiting for. We got the 50-50 raffle coming up.
$869.
And in case you were wondering, thanks again for everyone who was putting in money for this 50-50 raffle. We collected the money we're giving away is $869. So that is over $1,600 that was raised from this alone.
Dollar sales.
Yes.
All right, open it up, Katie.
I gotta take the lid off.
It's a lot of pressure. I'm gonna let Katie do this one.
No women.
Everyone, get your tickets ready.
6-8-2-3-8-1.
So, whoever has ticket number 6-8-2-3-8-1. Should we hold it? Or wait to claim it.
Right?
Huh?
What'd you say?
Keep going?
No.
Do we keep going until someone claims it?
No. I would call it again. I mean,
all right, I'm asked to call it again. We have 6-8-2-3-8-1. Is not present? Do we have to be present to win?
Yeah, I mean, how else are we going to know that they got the
okay,
winning
we
ticket?
Have to be present to win.
Okay. We're playing. You gotta be present to win. Doesn't look like there's a name on the back, so take two.
Oh, you like the red ones, I see. 2-2-4-2-1-8-3.
Do we have one? Wait, do they actually have it?
David Ross!
Woo! Congratulations, David!
In the silent auction, you'll receive a notification if they're the top bidder on their phone, and their payment will get processed. So I would just say, silent auction, they'll get pinged on their phone.
And everyone who has been bidding on things during the silent auction, we've got your name and number attached to it, so keep an eye on your phone. You will get pinged if you are the highest bidder and officially win the item. So thanks so much for everyone again for all of your donations through the 50. And David, thank you so much. It looks like he decided to donate it right back into the foundation. So that's even more money going to feeding families for Thanksgiving. And I think that's it. So, again, give it up one more time and make sure to find these guys. Keep them on the dance floor.